Greetings everyone! My name is Vizuvezad and I welcome you to the first analysis feedback video, where I present corrections, additions or supplements to previous game analysis episodes, which have arisen through posts and interactions in the comment section or discussions on other platforms. This time, we'll cover the name of the second pinball machine, the second photo on the fridge in Tifa's Bar 7th Heaven, the Chocobo Show ad poster, how Daylight may reach the Sector 7 slums, why I didn't mention Cloud's equipped materia, and the last comparison of trailer and gameplay presentation footage of the Scorpion Sentinel's ending scene. With that being said, let's get this thing started. In the analysis video, I interpreted that pinball machine's name as Gold Rush Tail 2. However, one commenter gave a probably more accurate interpretation of this pixel mess, and that is Gold Rush Pinball. I completely forgot to check the side label of the pinball machine. If we brighten it up a little, pinball is much more likely than the tail 2. Thanks for the info, Drifter02. Before we move on to the next point, I need to show you yet another Easter egg image I noticed while preparing for this video, and that's this framed photo above the Gold Rush pinball machine. Can you guess what it depicts? Yep, yet another still shot of Advent Children's version of 7th Heaven, but this time, it's the whole thing and not just a small portion like the other two. I'm mad at myself for not checking it out earlier. What was I thinking? Nothing, it seems. Anyway, on to the next point. Mrs. Rimavel mentioned in a comment that the second photo of the fridge in 7th Heaven could be something else. Funny thing is that I initially had the same idea when I looked at it the first time. It's very much possible that we see Barrett in his Advent Children outfit on there. I even found a still shot from Advent Children Complete, which fits almost perfectly. We can even see Marlene's head in the bottom left, though it seems they cut out Vincent and the stained glass window. It's weird to have a photo of the near future, but as the compilation is no longer canon, for now at least, this could also depict an alternate outfit for Barrett we may acquire in the game, which he might have worn in the past. Or it's just another Easter egg. Mrs. Rimavel, again, and another commenter were able to somewhat read the text at the bottom of the Chocobo Show ad poster. It seems to say Saturday and Sunday on the first line, and the stage times or opening hours underneath. After checking again, I can confirm that Saturday and Sunday seems the most likely, and when I know what to look for, it reads 6:00 PM-12:00 AM below. Thank you so much for helping me out here. That's what a community of awesome Final Fantasy fans is here for. Very much appreciated. Some commenters have also noted that there shouldn't be any sunlight in the slums for good reasons. At first, I thought so too, but there are ways for the sunlight to shine in. There are those gaps in between plates, letting sunlight in depending on the time and day and position underneath. The destroyed Sector 6 plate, where over half of it is missing, also contributes to more light in Sectors 5 and 7. Then there's also indirect light coming from outside of the plates. Aerith's church and home also receive some sunlight, and 7th Heaven is located closer to the outside than the central pillar, as it's located between the outer rim and the plate pillar, which seems to stand in the center of the plate. With that in mind, it's certainly possible that parts of Sector 7 could benefit from natural sunlight, albeit only indirect light. Ignore it once, and the community will call you out on it. Since I pointed it out so many times in previous analyses, I thought it's not necessary anymore to point out the materia slotted into Cloud's Buster Sword. How wrong I was. So from now on, I'll show you every single occurrence of equipped materia I can find. We're diligent, detailed, and thorough in our analyses, and not pointing out equipped materia is frankly a major oversight. Thank you, Kidsis, for reminding me. The following segment is not part of my commenter feedback, but about something I forgot to include in the bombing mission analysis and wasn't able to include in other analyses. We already got a glimpse of several parts of the Scorpion Sentinel's ending scene in multiple trailers. When comparing them to the gameplay demonstration version of the footage, we can see several differences. The major difference is the lighting. In the trailers, there's more green light, whereas the gameplay demonstration contains more red colors to emphasize the destruction. The lightning angle also seems different. Another change pertains to fog. There's more fog and smoke in the air in the trailers, obscuring the background to a higher degree. There are also smaller differences like slight animation and position altering of limbs, accessories and debris. Barrett's jacket and dog tag necklace are the most affected by this animation change, as well as the falling strut debris from the ceiling blocking access to the bomb. During the big explosion, Cloud's angle also changes. His posture is the same, but his whole 3D model is turned a little to the left in the gameplay demonstration. In the trailers, the strut segment falls, keeping angle and positioning upon landing, which isn't really physically accurate. That's probably why they changed that, as seen in the gameplay demo. There, it has a different angle while falling, and it rolls slightly towards Barrett until it comes to halt, assuming the same position as seen in the trailers. Regarding the bomb, a major oversight happened in the trailers. They completely forgot to place the model of the bomb onto the pump regulator in this shot here. This isn't the case in other shots. As we can see here, the model of the pump regulator also changes slightly, textures as well as the 3D mesh. In this shot, where the Scorpion Sentinel starts charging up its laser, we can make out some changes done to the background. There are two notable ones. The suspended bridge leading through the room is missing most of the tarps hung over the railing in the gameplay demonstration. Instead, there are two instances of cloth strings of sorts strung around and along the railing. And above the entrance, there are several lights missing as well. 6 tubular lamps and 2 spotlights. In addition to that, some of the wall lamp arrays are now illuminated, while others are not. Fire particles and explosions also differ significantly, most likely due to some tweaking of the particle and effect parameters. This can be seen best when the Scorpion Sentinel starts exploding and is slipping off the bridge when looking at the fires on the ground, the falling burning debris and the explosion plumes. The explosion of the pipes behind the pump regulator was also changed heavily as seen here. In the trailers, it's more centered and covers the bomb. That's probably why they changed it, as the new version has the explosion trajectory off to the sides, completely missing the bomb. Additionally, this makes it look like the explosion comes from behind the pump regulator and not the regulator element itself, which was most likely the intention behind the change. Another difference I'm kind of miffed about is texture resolution. It's especially apparent on Barrett's model, where several details are blurrier or have less details altogether in the gameplay demonstration footage. Either the gameplay demonstration has been recorded on a base PS4, or the trailers were captured on a developer PC with a hardware configuration similar to a PS4 Pro. Either way, that's it for this analysis addendum. And incidentally also for this first analysis feedback video. I might do this again depending on feedback and free time. This week, I won't be able to finish my next game analysis episode by Friday 13th, and as Tokyo Game Show is throwing a wrench in my schedule with new Final Fantasy VII Remake content, I'm going to put out some other content over the weekend in place of the normal uploads. That's why I took the time to create this short feedback video. However, I'll try to finish the penultimate E3 2019 trailer scenes and locations analysis by Friday, September 20th, and the last one 1 week after. Anyway, I'm curious about your thoughts on this type of video and the contents therein. Leave a like if you enjoyed it, subscribe if you're new, hit the bell button to be immediately notified of future uploads, and don't let yourself stop from sharing this video around. That being said, thank you so much for listening in, and I hope to see you again in the next analysis feedback session. And always remember, stay safe and take care. Bisous Azath, signing off.